Digital Pedagogia in Higher Education, Professor Andrea de Bem Machado. Biography. I am from Brazil. I live in the south of Brazil in the city called Florianópolis. I have a degree in pedagogy with a master in science and technology education and a PhD in engineering and knowledge management. Currently, in addition to working at two universities in Brazil, I am a doing postdoctor. Today, I am here to talk to you about digital pedagogy in the higher education. Higher education. The educational landscape has undergone a substantial transformation as a result of education and new technologies. The educational context that in the pandemic year of 2020 has undergone a substantial change with the use of information and communication technologies is shooting through a pedagogy steep in scientific and technical knowledge. This scientific-based knowledge aims to explain structural practices, methodological procedures for intervention and coordination of knowledge and action for the dissemination and approach of knowledge. Higher education is the subject of this presentation because it is necessary to rethink educational practices in all forms of education. Thus, in the scenario marked by the COVID-19 pandemic associated with prof social, economic, and cultural transformation and the rapid development of digital information and communication technologies, higher education institutions have been faced with the need to redefine themselves and rethink in order to keep up with the technological changes of the postmodern world. Digital pedagogy, rethink new pedagogical techniques and practices that involve technological tools in teacher practice. This practice can be called digital pedagogy, which uses technological means in the teacher methods combined with the adoption of more dynamic learning process. What is pedagogy? Pedagogy encompasses more that just the application of teaching and learning strategies and procedures. It deals with the interaction of which human being believes and values and their implication for the teaching and learning process. It also emphasizes assumption about the relationship between learning and teaching was well the methodology, strategy, and the technologies to be used in the classroom context. Digital technological. Anderson 2020 states that the pedagogical methods and strategy students in pedagogy prepare students for living by developing their intellectual person and social research. In 2020, with the emergence of the COVID-19 pandemic, online learning and teaching were pushed with the use of digital technology. In the context, teachers had to learn who they use these technologies to deliver their lesson, which inspired new education policies. Information and communication technology. Having the ability to use information and communication technologies to find evaluation, creation, and communication, information requires cognitive and technical skill is a competence. This competence constitutes a concept called is digital literacy, which the teacher came to have with CRIT4 in the year 2020. Digital Pedagogy, in the context of higher education, professors are increasingly required to have technological skills. Thus, digital literacy alone is not enough to meet the demands that professors and students faced with the COVID-19 pandemic, which accelerated the adoption of digital pedagogy. After all, what is digital pedagogy? The term digital pedagogy is difficult to conceptualize because it can be viewed from many angles. Simply put, digital pedagogy can refer to the use of technological elements to enhance or change the educational experience. Kinfuse defined digital pedagogy as the ability to integrate digital technologies into teacher to enhance learning, teacher assessment, and curriculum. Dimension of digital pedagogy. Propose of a digital pedagogy paired with the three dimensions: pedagogy orientation, pedagogy practice, and digital pedagogy skill. Dimension of digital pedagogy. Pedagogical orientation is defined as the teacher perspective of who the learning process should be conducted, who individuals should learn, and who they should be instructed and advised. It carries out the teacher proposed strategy according to their pedagogical intentions. Dimension of digital pedagogy. The term pedagogy practice refers to the teacher methods used by the teacher. Digital pedagogical competencies are defined as the skill that teacher must possess to successfully integrate digital technologies into the classroom. Digital pedagogy competencies include pedagogical, digital, ethical, and enhanced skill according a show in figure. Digital pedagogy consists of three competencies. Digital pedagogy is competence of three competencies. Pedagogical competency, which consists of having subjective matter knowledge, experience in the teacher methods, and experience in the professor living skill. Digital competence, on the other hand, involve having knowledge of digital technologies and having the ability to use it. Understand the potential of digital technology and using it in teaching. Ethical competence, which involve being attentive to the equality of students, primary the learning experience, and emphasis digital literacy. Digital pedagogical consists of three competencies in the context that competencies proposed by digital pedagogy do not only focus on the use of digital technologies from teaching, but also discuss and reflect on approach to technological tool and their use the educational context. Digital pedagogy. It's the use of digital tool in the full way as the design when do not choose then and to pay attention to their impact on learning. Digital pedagogy not only promotes interaction and free exchange of knowledge between student and professor, by also inspiring innovation and chance. Digital learning. In this context, there is digital learning, which is the term used to design the teacher methods that using technology is means to accessible education goals. Digital learning. The learning which is called digital is any learning activity that uses information and communication technologies in a meaningful way. In terms of learning, teachers have to rethink themselves from the changes of society, mediate and connect by various technologies. Digital learning. The introduction of digital tool has changed the pedagogical methods of teaching and learning, along the creation of activities in different formats and more stimulating of student interaction and engagement. Online multimídia. Research, test, image, audio, crafts, animation, video, virtual reality, digitalization, works are part of digital pedagogy a concept that includes digital learning and that tends to consolidate more and more. What are the main threats in digital learning? Among we can explain here. Mobile learning, mobile device, especially smartphone and tablets, are the primary equipment that students own, even which display expression of technology not everyone has access to computers or laptops. What are the main trends in digital learning? Gamification. Gamification is the term used for the application of game dynamics to school activities in order to further engage students in digital learning. Virtual reality. Virtual reality is a way to create more immersive experience for students with digital learning. In the way, even if the student is far from the space or a museum, they can feel as if they are in two places. Microlearning, another trend brought about by digital learning is microlearning, which is a teaching approach that gives the context into smaller objective models with children actively propose. Futurist scenario of higher education. This the future scenario for higher education in the digital age will have as its methodology the adoption of machine learning, artificial intelligence, blockchain, Internet of Things, Industrial 4.0, these future technologies that will be used in the teacher learning process where students in learning and relearning differ in area where the interface with technology in more evident or in area that are impacted by the process of social Technical construction. Thank you. Reference.